नमस्कार आणि येऊकार तुमका याच्या खाशेल्या कार्यावळीत. वेल हॅलो करियर हो कार्यक्रम बऱ्याच स्टेपानंतर आम्ही तुमच्या मुखार घेऊन येता. फाटले काही 2 वर्षं ऑब्व्हियसली कोविड पॅन्डेमिकाच्या निमतान भुरगीं घरातकडे स्टक असली, ऑनलाईन त्यांचे एड्युकेशन चलताले, पण आता खरी जग परत ओपन जाता. ऑब्व्हियसली वी आर हिटिंग 1 बिलियन डोसेस इन टर्म्स ऑफ वॅक्सिनेशन, सो होपफुली डिसेंबरानंतर थिंग्स विल बी बॅक इन टू ॲक्शन आणि तसेच एड्युकेशन सेक्टर सुद्धा परत रिवाईव्ह जातलो. आणि ऑब्व्हियसली जेव्हा एड्युकेशन म्हणतात त्यांना ऑब्व्हियसली आम्ही बाहेर वचून शिक्षण घेतात, ते मागीर पुण्या जावं किंवा वेगवेगळे सिटीज जावं. आणि एक सिटी जी आमकां खूप क्लोज असा आणि आम्ही बरेचसे गोयकार जे शिक्षण घेतात बेळगावी सारखे शिक्षण संस्थेन आणि बऱ्यापैकी थंयसर शिक्षण संस्था असा, वेगवेगळ्यो संस्था असा. आणि आयज अशाच एका संस्थेबद्दल आम्ही उलयतले आणि माझ्या बरोबर असा 2 स्पेशल गेस्ट. ते म्हणजे एक असा डॉक्टर आनंद देशपांडे, प्रिन्सिपल अँड डिरेक्टर ॲट अंगडी इन्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नॉलॉजी अँड मॅनेजमेंट, आणि तसेच माझ्या बरोबर असा एच एस पाटील, प्रिन्सिपल अंगडी स्कूल ऑफ आर्किटेक्चर. सर वेलकम टू द शो. ओके, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल जस्ट टू स्टार्ट द बॉल रोलिंग, ऑब्व्हियसली कोविड पॅन्डेमिक हॅज यू नो हिट अस बॅडली, एज्युकेशन सेक्टर वॉज नो डिफरंट. जस्ट टू स्टार्ट द शो, हाव हॅज बीन युअर एक्सपिरियन्स इन द फर्स्ट प्लेस?
लास्ट 1.5 years ड्यू टू कोविड द एज्युकेशन सेक्टर वॉज अफेक्टेड बॅडली, अँड ड्युरिंग दिस टाइम अवर फॅकल्टीज यूज टू कंडक्ट ऑनलाईन क्लासेस अँड दिस वॉज एंटायरली न्यू कन्सेप्ट, ऑर यू कॅन से न्यू कल्चर. New culture for our students as well as faculty members. And faculties from our institute are well qualified and they conducted online classes to train our students, which never affected our students' education during a COVID tough time also.
Okay, so Patil, if you can just brief us, because architecture happens to be a very niche subject where a lot of on-field experience has to be garnered. Obviously, you can't do it online. How has been your experience in terms of imparting education?
Definitely, you have touched a very right point when you are talking about architecture, because there is a lot of hands-on work which goes with the students and the faculty. And when the lockdown was announced, we have to move to a newer system which was online mode. And we were thinking how to put the students into the right track. But we made a system like if there are any sites which are been happening also, because sometimes construction was allowed in the pandemic lockdown, and we asked the students like if you can go to the nearest wherever the construction is happening and do a video and shoot it and put it onto the cell phone media, so that other people also get benefited who are not in touch, who are in a very secluded area where they cannot get into the education of what we can say hands-on education. So that has been a very challenging moment, but our trained teachers could achieve it, and we very well efficiently handled the pandemic and trained our students so that they don't lose their career, because it has been nearly 1 year we went online and we could do the best, and they even passed the exams. Even for architecture, the VTU said we will hold Viva. And we did conduct online Viva, and we were very successful, and our students did a very great work.
Okay, obviously Angadi Education Foundation doesn't require an introduction here in Goa. There's a lot of students that you have imparted, you are part of this foundation. I just want to ask you for my viewers who are watching this on understanding this about Angadi is the first time. I just want to ask you is Dr. Deshpande, Angadi Institute of Technology and Management, if somebody wants to enroll for the next maybe academic year, what is that USP that you have, and why should somebody travel to Belgavi to take education?
Suresh Angadi Education Foundation, established in 2009 under this banner, Angadi Institute of Technology and Management was also established. And this is established by our beloved chairman, beloved founder chairman, late Sri Suresh Angadi sir, who was a visionary and was an educationalist, who always inspired our students, or we can say engineering aspirants, to learn the technologies. So he started this institute in 2009 with only 4 branches, like electrical, electronics and communication engineering, and mechanical and civil. So there, just a few points about our founder chairman is late Sri Suresh Angadi sir, who was elected 4 times as a member of parliament, and he was a union minister for railways, states of Indian Railways. And In this time, I mean, in 2009, after the establishment of AITM, he introduced various postgraduate courses also. And in next 2 years, AITM has got 6 undergraduate programs, 1 MBA, Master of Business Administration, and 1 program in Master of Computer Application, and 2 PG, that is M.Tech programs in civil as well as mechanical engineering. So recently we have introduced a new engineering course, that is upcoming engineering course, Artificial Intelligence and Data Science. In North Karnataka, this AITM is the first institute to introduce AI and data science. So and now we have received a NAAC accreditation from Government of India, and now we are heading towards NBA. We have really a good campus which has got in campus boys hostel as well as girls hostel. And for the students, the local students, we have transportation facility. And this campus is located in lush green area, which is purely dedicated for education only. We do not have any other distraction in our institute. So where student only learn different subjects, and not only learning, they understand various technologies. And we introduce or we conduct various seminars as well as conferences to give a practical exposure to our students.
Okay.
And with this, we have various placements. Reputed companies, they visit our company, visit our institute, and they recruit our students. We have dedicated faculty members who are pursuing their PhD, and many of the faculties are doctorates, they have PhDs, and they are well-known faculties in international level also.
Okay.
Many faculties are in collaboration with international universities where they are pursuing their research work. Like this, we have a dedicated team in our institute.
Okay.
This is about our institute.
If I can ask Mr. Patil, sir, how has been your journey when it comes to Angadi School of Architecture? What have been the milestones and, you know, achievements that your institute has been able to give to the students?
Yeah, Angadi School of Architecture was established by our late Sri Suresh Angadi ji, who was very visionary, and he wanted to give a affordable education to the rural part of that area and to the nearest part of the Karnataka and bordering areas. So he started it in 2016. And starting in School of Architecture is not an easy job, because there are a lot of regulations which are laid out by Council of Architecture, which controls the whole system of education in architecture. And to apply that and move ahead, it's a very challenging task. And Sri Suresh Angadi took that task and established it in 2016. I joined Angadi School of Architecture in 2018. Earlier, I was working as a professor in one of the college which was nearby Hubli, that is KLE University. And I graduated from the same college. I did my master's from Manipal Institute in Advanced Architecture. And we recently completed first batch, which has come out, because architecture is a 5-year course. So 2016 we started, and 2021 our first batch has come out. And of the first batch, everyone has got employed, and they are doing successfully, working in the best of the architectural firms. And to say about Angadi School of Architecture, there is something called as a biggest student association, that is called as NASA, National Association of Students of Architecture. And it conducts one of the best conventions in the entire part of India. And it's the largest organization in the entire part of Asia, student organization. And we have been participating in that. We have been winning good prizes in terms of design, in terms of our kind of work and execution. And in one of the semester, we have something called as urban design. And our students have really done very well with the urban design studio. They have presented a good work and good development. So the journey is very good, and the students are doing really good. And the achievements are very, very high. And because the facilities what we provide in the area, and in the specific region, is quite high, with a team of good teachers and eminent faculties and professors, we are able to achieve a good number of students.
So the response has been amazing so far, and since you have been out with the first batch of graduates from your institute. Dr. Deshpande, I would like to ask you a very pertinent question. Is engineering used to be a very lucrative field for a lot of people, you know, across streams. Of late, you know, people, you know, have a second thought. Now, since you're working in that field, is still engineering something to, you know, go to, or has it lost its charm maybe because there are a lot of you know, students taking admission? Why should somebody take engineering as a stream?
Well, this is a really good question. World is focusing more on research, innovation in technologies. So, after, I mean, by doing engineering, we can contribute to this society, or we can contribute to this world by developing our own products. And this is not possible, or we can say very less chances if we do not join engineering courses. Everywhere you go, anywhere, you require technology. Even small mobile, it requires technology. And for that technologies, engineers are required. So such, there is lot of scope for engineers. People may say it is losing interest or it is losing its value. No, it is not like that. You go anywhere. You take any one small example like any NASA or any satellite launching this thing organization. They are launching different satellites and many, you can take another example, GPS. GPS is developed by engineers only. Satellites, it gives a real-time images or real-time data to our mobile. And this is possible by using only engineers. Engineers can design and develop such products. So there is a never-ending, what we say, there is no any stop for engineering, or you can say technology. It is evergreen field. So there is lot of demand now as well as in the future for engineering graduates.
Okay. Patil sir, again same question to you with respect to your field. Now architecture, I remember, you know, 10 or 20 years ago, it used to be the corporates and, you know, the huge design houses that you would see, you know, employing architecture or maybe having this architectural sense. Of late that has changed. It has come down to, you know, even residential areas, you know, small houses as well, you know, engage an architect with them, and obviously they plan it way ahead of before they execute. You know, how has been the response, and, you know, is it still lucrative, or has it again, you know, because of maybe COVID or maybe other, as real estate has taken backseat? How do you see your first batch of graduates and also the next couple of batches that will come out of your institute, and you see how India is progressing?
Definitely, because see, any course around Roti Kapda Makan is a hit course. Okay, so because architecture being a course which is very much related to housing, and definitely it will put our students or the graduates or the graduated architects into a best position. And architecture is a course which has been blended with engineering technology, a bit of humanities, a bit of environmental science. So it's a blend of two, three courses. And a person who takes up an architecture course becomes more sensitive to the existing society and how to deal with it and how to respond to what is happening around. And earlier, as you said, it used to be a little bit corporate kind of I mean, people used to employ architects because they used to consider architects are the costliest people who charge a lot of fees. But equally, when it comes to giving an output, architects design spaces which are very, very much cohesive with the environment, which are very much psychologically feel good, and environment will be there in the spaces which you would like to live on. And what happens is, like, when the students or the architects who graduate, they do the justice to the client. So, and now it is like something like affordable housing, and we want to do best to the society and build environments which are which will pull down the crime rate and make social accessibility. So many things are there.
Also the green about element that you know, a
definitely
lot of people
are green element, and we can talk about sustainability. So architecture teaches you and takes you into that journey. So many students are offering, because when I started architecture, it was just 40 colleges. That was way back in 1991 and 96.
This is across India?
Yeah, across India. So now there are 400 colleges when we are talking about architecture. So this makes sense that there are people who want to afford and take up architecture as a career and become architects. And there are opportunities where people have gone out of the country also. That is one of the element where, because architecture is a valid course throughout the world. So it's not just India or anywhere. Architects have a valid position in many of the other countries. So students take it up and do the justice, and there is no architect who has been left unemployed, because it's a professional course where you can immediately start your own office as soon as you graduate, and you start getting the clients, and you will have your own setup of employees, and you can start working. So it, being a professional course, it is one of the best career options with people who are really creative and can do something best. Because see, you can become an architect and be a product designer or a photographer, anything like that. But being a product designer, you cannot become an architect. So architects is the mother of all creative arts. It's called like that.
So you need to have a base of architecture if you want to do maybe into product design.
Yeah, yeah. Those are the allied fields which can get into the professions.
Dr. Deshpande, another thing is we all know about the VTU university that you have, you know, in your vicinity. Now, how important it is to have being affiliated to such kind of a premier institute, and how has it helped, you know, maybe structuring your institute as well?
Okay. VTO, this is the Visvesvaraya Technological University. This is in Belagavi. AITM is affiliated to VTU, and we follow their syllabus. And this university comes under less than 50 near ranking all over India. This is such a top university. This university sets the syllabus based on the requirements. Requirements in the sense latest technologies. The university decides the syllabus depending on the, discussing with various experts in the industries, and then they set the syllabus, and we follow those syllabuses. And here we train our students as per that syllabus. That means more than 1 lakh students from entire Karnataka will be following this syllabus, and students who excel in this, that directly indicates ki they are expert in more than 1 lakh students. They are experts in the among these 1 lakh students. But when we compare with other things like autonomous or any standalone universities, such thing will not be there. There will be a very less competition, and we cannot say ki we are top amongst 1 lakh students or 2 lakh students. They are only limited, hardly 60 or 100 or maximum 1000 students. This itself shows ki students from VTU affiliated institutes are more capable to handle any situation, or they can develop, or they can be expert in latest technology. So in this manner, VTU helps us to tune or train our students in latest technologies.
Okay. Also, Patil sir, I want to ask you is, in terms of student involvement, in terms of students doing their projects, you know, how important it is. Especially maybe if we consider another year, we're still in COVID. Based with COVID or without COVID, how important it is to have students' projects, and how do you encourage them to, you know, excel in making such kind of projects?
Yeah, when you look into architectural syllabus, out of the eight subjects, you will have four as a studio subject, which are very much practically
classroom,
practical classroom, where hands-on work is very much needed. The students go out, they do a lot of field work and come back, data collection, then they put it onto the either computer or on the sheets, and they work. And basically what happens is like a personal interview with the clients, okay, also takes them to the next level when they want to deal with the projects. So this happens right from the classroom level, because every semester we have a vertical called a design studio, and as the semester goes on, the capacity of the studio increases. Like if you are doing a residence at the first year level, when you reach the final year or the eighth semester level, you will be handling a urban level project. So here the student has to be very proactive in taking up the projects. He cannot be reactive. So he has to think, he has to evaluate, he has to come out with the options and deliver the best things to the client. And though there are imaginary clients in the studio work, we still make them feel that they are the real clients, and give them the practical experience. So the moment they come out from their architectural graduation, they are very much confident in handling the real world projects and real world clients. So that's why we train with that. That's how the architecture moves.
Okay. Anandji, obviously, with respect to engineering and project, how important it is. And also, I would like to know, this is in the classroom. And obviously, when you do an internship, which is very important, to, just to understand, you know, how the system or how the business work, you also have three internships introduced in engineering by AICTE. Also, speak about the project and also this internship.
During engineering courses, a student will study theory as well as practicals, which are interrelated to each other. But while working or when they enter into job domain, they must have practical exposure. And nowadays, the technology is growing in such a way, it is very fast. So after completing their engineering courses, if any student join any courses or if he or she wants to understand, or if he or she wants to understand the system, then it is a bit difficult. So university as well as AICT has introduced a new concept, that is internship. So recently they have introduced three internships during 4 years engineering courses, every year one internship. As of now, only one internship is there. In this internship period, students will understand how the company or how any system works. Not only in terms of technology, they will learn many concepts like handling financial management, entrepreneurship. Such things they will learn during internship. This is much required. This is much required in engineering curriculum. So we have this concept, and students are undergoing various internships through our institute, where we have MOU with those institutes. Our students are learning and they are understanding various concepts about industries. And next point is about project. Project gives you hands-on experiences. None of the companies, they want to train any students after their engineering courses. So what they are doing is they are supporting all the institutes to develop projects which may be useful for their company. So their students will get practical knowledge. And using that practical knowledge, they can perform well in the institutes. And during, I mean, while working on these projects, students may get various ideas, or we can say they can provide solutions for latest technologies, latest technical problems. So for them, we, I mean, engineering courses, they provide this project scheme where they can develop their own product, and later on they can start their own company. So like this, it will help our students to start their own company, or we can say entrepreneurship.
Okay. Patil sir, also I would like to know about the internship part of it, and also since your institute is based in Belgavi, do you encourage students or maybe you have tie-up with corporate houses or design houses which are out of Karnataka or maybe Belgavi, and engage your students to take up internship so that they get the best of the experience?
Yeah. Before we shift on to internship, one point I would to specify is there is a pre-screening done before you enter to architecture.
Okay.
So there is an exam called as NATA.
Entrance exam.
Yeah, National Aptitude Test in Architecture, which is hosted by Council of Architecture. And it's very mandatory to pass that exam. Without passing that exam, a candidate cannot get into architecture. And the second point is like he has to be from the science background or the diploma background. So earlier it used to be 50% in overall and PCM 50% aggregate. And even if you are in a diploma, any stream or discipline, we are admitting those students. But there also it has to be 50%. But this year, because of pandemic, they have reduced it to 35%.
Okay.
And the passing marks for NATA also is reduced from 80 to 70. And NATA is a mandatory exam to pass and to get into architecture. So once they get into architecture, it is a 5-year course. And the internship is in the 9th semester as per the VTO syllabus. What they do is they go for one whole semester to an architect, under an architect they work for 120 days, that is a whole semester. And after that there's a viva on that. And before going there, they start applying with their resumes and the type of work they have done in the under semesters. If I'm saying it is starting at 9th semester, all the 8 semester works, they would do a portfolio, send it to the well-known architects who have some opening for the interns. So either a bigger office or a smaller office, we encourage wherever they want to pursue, because it's all based on their interest. Suppose somebody wants to pursue something like in a green architecture, they look out for an office that actually curtails that particular kind of projects. If they, somebody wants to look into something like very contemporary type of architecture, They choose those kind of offices and enroll themselves there.
Okay.
So they appear for interview. Once they are assigned with the job, they complete it. Once they are back, there is a viva based on that. Then they qualify for that. Then the 10th semester would be something called as a thesis. It's a project which will be handled by one student and one guide. So what happens, they make a choice of a project, a larger project. Since they have learnt most of the things in the under semester, they make a choice of a bigger project. Entirely they handle it by themselves. They go for a case study. They make the project, how large the project has to be. And then there is a guide who will guide them. And finally, there is a viva for that particular project. After that, they get graduated. So that gives them the confidence that alone they can handle the whole system when they go out into the natural environment of architectural practice.
Okay. Dr. Deshpande, with respect to Angadi Institute of Technology and Management, obviously, you know, everybody is always proud of the alumni that is there, you know, working with the corporate houses, known, renowned, or maybe more importantly, who are, you know, self-reliant and working, have their own setup. How do you see your alumni base with respect to your institute?
For institutes, alumni base is much required. Where our current students will come to know about various technologies or various aspects after the engineering by our alumni students. So we have such a huge alumni base where our alumni are training our current engineering students. And in our institute, we have introduced a new concept where our alumni will be the mentors for students. And these mentors will guide the students. And many alumni, they have supported us for the placements also. Many companies are visiting our institute and recruiting our students just because of our alumni. They are contributing a lot to this institute. And in this 10 to 12 years, we have a number of alumni, and they are still supporting us in terms of recruitment, in terms of engineering, internship, as well as projects. They are supporting our students. Like this, we have very strong alumni base.
Okay, Mr. Patil, since your first batch is out, you know, maybe some have already been recruited, some are, you know, working. How do you see your alumni base with respect to the times that we are in, and since it is your first batch?
Yeah, see, as architects, we always think like kuch alag karna hai, we have to be something little different. So the moment the first batch was out and on the graduation day, we took a step that at least once in a year we will meet back. So we have decided that January 26th, we'll form an association, which is already underway now. On January 26th, every year, we will have a meet of alumni. So that people who have gone into different areas of working could come back and give back to the institution and train the people who are already joined architecture. So that one strong point we want to focus. And it will be like a design festival. We will call the students who have achieved something in their career. As well as people, I mean, the bigger architects or the senior architects, we'll have a kind of competition. And by the alumni association, we want to support the people who are looking for some kind of help in kind of fees or scholarship or something like that. If somebody can sponsor some students who are really interested in to take up architecture as a profession. So through alumni association, we want to do all these things. So we'll be meeting in 2022-26 January. That will be our first meet, and we are looking for a good success in that. And most of the students have said yes, and we are planning to register under the Society Acts also, that one. So that it becomes a global movement. That's what we are looking into.
Vaslo, hello career chi hi amchi karyavar. फोकस असलो आमचो बेळगावीन जे इन्स्टिट्यूट असा तितूर आणि आयज आम्ही विजिट केलं ते ऑब्व्हियसली अंगडी इन्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नॉलॉजी अँड मॅनेजमेंट अँड ऑब्व्हियसली अंगडी स्कूल ऑफ आर्किटेक्चर.
वी थँक प्रुडंट फॉर दी वंडरफुल लोकेशन व्हॉट दे प्रोव्हाइडेड टू अस टू एक्झिबिट अवर स्कूल अँड दी कॉलेज इंजिनिअरिंग कॉलेज व्हॉट वी हॅव. प्लीज डू कम जॉईन अस अँड ग्रो विथ अस. दॅट्स दी वर्ड व्हॉट वी कॅन से. Thank you.
We request our aspirants, engineering aspirants, to visit our institute and have the knowledge about engineering and future career. Once again, thank you very much.
So that's all from me on this special program of Hello Career. Gentlemen, thank you very much for joining. And tumhi khay tosa nakat, pulay taravat, Prudent.